Hey guys, I'm CP. I'm the physical therapist here in Austin, Texas. Been talking to you guys a little bit about posture in some of the previous videos. And today I wanna bring you an assessment that you can actually do at home to sort of look and see where your posture is, if you've got good pec flexibility, if you're able to move those shoulders in the positions we need them to be so that you guys can maintain good alignment. And this is Lucy, she's gonna be helping me today and we're gonna do a wall angel. So the wall angel is one of those assessments that whether you're an athlete or you sit at a desk all day, you're at home, this is one of those things where you want to make sure that you have the appropriate range of motion and the mobility and flexibility of all the muscles that surround those joints so that you can whether perform at your best or you're lifting weights or you can actually maintain good posture during the workday so that you're not having issues with tension headaches, upper back pain, rib dysfunction, low back pain, all the things that I would see in the clinic. This is a way that you can really check yourself. And when you do some of the exercises and stretches and mobility movements that we're gonna talk to you about today, then you can reassess yourself and see if you're actually making some progress using the wall angel. The first thing I recommend is you target is the T-spine, right? This thoracic spine. This is where most of the restrictions from the joint is gonna come, especially when we're talking about posture, right? Because everybody's very flexed all day and this is sort of where some of that happens first. You can use a plexus, you can use a foam roller. I'm looking for something that's just gonna have a nice broad curve to it. And I'm gonna have Lucy come back. She'll lay right on this. And just watch your hair. Perfect. And the first thing you wanna do is protect your neck, right? So she's gonna put her hands back here. You can clasp them, you can hold them together, however you need to, but what you don't wanna do is let that neck fall back into extension. You really wanna just get it so you can leave your bottom on the ground and you're really looking now for this arch, right? You wanna target that upper back that gets really stiff and flexed in that posture all day, especially if you're at a desk. Here, what the one thing you're looking for too is you don't want to come down to the lumbar spine to get that, right? You'll have plenty of access to extension here. It's here that you really want to target that. So you can kind of just oscillate over each little segment. And how do you feel here? You feel that kind of mobilizing. It's sort of a little bit of pressure up into one. Okay, and then once you've done that, and now you can sit up for me, you're going to want to get a little bit more specific. Some people use like two tennis balls taped together or two lacrosse balls, or you can put them in a sock. Obviously my preference is the Mobo just because it has a dual ball unit so that these guys have a special texture and a raised edge so they can really kind of dig into some of the muscles in there and then you can do the same extension. This is more specific this time. So Luce, I'm gonna put this here. You're gonna just drop back. And then this one again, block that head. And then this is just more aggressive, a little bit more specific. It's gonna be more uncomfortable. So always prep that tissue and prep extension with some kind of big flat surface. And then now bring these knees up, protect that low back. And then now she's getting some more specific extension, mobilization, and also a little bit of soft tissue through those paraspinal muscles, those muscles that run all the way down the spine. Okay, now this time I had Lucy put her hair up. It's really important, especially ladies, you don't want your hair getting caught in any of the devices you're gonna be using to mobilize. And also make sure t-shirts don't get kind of knotted up or balled up. You do want maybe some kind of surface here so that protects the skin. And then, what I'm gonna do is use the Mobo Mini. These are the areas right here that you're sort of gonna want to address, again, for posture. This is where that flexed posture is gonna come into. And then I've also grabbed a Mobo block. This happens to be covered with neoprene, so you can actually take it off, wash it, in case it gets gross and sweaty. And so I'm gonna lay it long ways, and then Lucy's gonna lay back. Good. And then, her head will now rest on the block. Knees are up, that protects the low back. First thing I'm gonna do is have her hands to her side. So now she doesn't have to worry about her neck anymore, right? But it does need to be in neutral. And then she's gonna slightly lift off the ground and then she can do just a little bit of rolling on those two points of contact in the T-spine. Then she can set herself down And now if you wanna just have some sustained pressure here, she can bring her arms up in the air, bring them together. This exposes a little bit of those rib angles, that musculature that surrounds the spine. She can rock back and forth. She can come this way. All of that just sort of helps mobilize that joint. And then you can move to the next segment wherever you're feeling that restriction at this point. Okay, so once you've addressed the thoracic spine, right, and got that moving a little bit, now what we wanna do is we're gonna go to the wall and actually address some of the pectoralis muscles, open those shoulders up. I'll show you a few more stretches that we can do to get the rest of this wall angel to look like we want it to look like this one's. So first thing you need is a wall. All you're really gonna be thinking about with a wall angel, there's several ways to do it. This is just my favorite. It allows for a little bit of cheat for those of you who are really gonna be struggling with some posture. So once you get to the wall, you just kinda wanna get yourself set. I'm gonna have you do a few directional things with your abs, your shoulders, but basically you'll end up sorta looking like this. All right, if you have some issues, do not be concerned if you're like, oh my God, you can't get your head back here, your arms are way away from the wall. Those are just indications that you're definitely gonna need to be working on some of the flexibility and mobility exercises we're gonna give you today. So remember, you sorta wanna be against a wall, you're gonna be having this much room you're gonna be required to have to really see what the wall angel looks like. All right, so now I'm gonna have Lucy come to the wall. Let me show you what it really should look like. Couple things you wanna think about. You wanna put your feet anywhere from 6 to 12 inches from the wall. Further is a little bit easier, so say you really need to cheat at this point, you can bring those feet out just a little bit more. You wanna have a slight bend in your knees, and then you wanna rest your bottom and the low back against the wall. Once this happens, then you wanna try to, I call this kind of a 2-for-1 exercise, because not only do I get to see her mobility and flexibility of her T-spine and her shoulders, but at the same time, I'm gonna ask those deep core muscles to your abs, transverse abdominis muscles, those are like a foundation to posture. And this is where you get to check and see if those guys are working the way you want them to. So Lucy's basically gonna try to touch all of her back to the wall. Basically, you don't wanna be able to slide your hand behind her, right? That's how you can check, or somebody can check for you. Again, you want complete contact to the wall here. Then once you have that set, now Lucy's gonna bring her arms up to 90 degrees. She's gonna place her whole head against the wall as well. She's gonna tuck this chin just slightly. You want as much contact from the back of your head to the top of your buttocks, all touching the wall. That's how you know you've got these guys recruited the way you need to. And then now look, honestly, she's flawless. This is what it should look like. You should have your arms fully contacting the wall, the wrists and hands should be fully contacting the wall. She might be feeling a little bit of strain between her shoulder blades. Those are called the periscapular muscles. Those are responsible for also helping hold you in good posture. So again, I'm getting to see flexibility of her pecs, mobility of her thoracic spine, and she's getting to recruit her transverse abdominis, those deep ab muscles, and her periscapular muscles between the shoulder blades, all which help hold her in good alignment. This is what you should look like. If you don't, no worries, but this again is what you're gonna be striving for once we give you some tools to make this happen. Okay, so some of the dysfunctions you might see, and this might be you, and this is how you'll know what you need to target. First, if you can't get your deep abs recruited, you're gonna come away from the wall. And if you can see this space back here, your job is to, number one, see if you can figure that out. Use this wall as a tactile cue, right? Something that you can feel pressure. Have somebody put their hand back there. You try to squeeze it, squish it. See if you can get those abs recruited. So that's number one. Number two, if you have really tight pec muscles, what'll happen is these wrists come off the wall, right? This pec becomes so short and tight and dominant, you literally can't even touch the wall with your fingers, let alone put that wrist to the wall. So this is an area we definitely need to address. And this is for all you people that sit at a desk and type all day, or texters, or you're at the gym and you do a lot of anterior chain exercises. This is what you're gonna look like. But imagine if you could have access to this motion, how much more efficient and effective you would be with whether it's lifting weights or having good posture at work, because this is where some of those issues come from for neck pain and upper back pain. And then imagine too, if Lucy has a forward head, right? We talked about that in one of the videos. She's gonna be trying to reach the wall, but she'll keep trying to push her head back. And again, that means that these guys are long and weak and that these guys are short and tight back here. And you want this chin to be able to get into a neutral position. That's how you know this alignment is happening. So you're looking for some of those things during this particular assessment for a wall angel. So once you've got this position, a couple of things you can do. Again, you're gonna be getting some recruitment of these abs in this position. That's already gonna be a little bit taxing for you. It's an exercise. Also, I bet you $1 million Lucy's feeling this between her shoulder blades. She's struggling right now. That in and of itself is an exercise. Just try to hold this position if you can, maybe 5 seconds if you can, 10 seconds, and then relax, get out of it, shake your arms out, try it again. Also, if you feel like this is getting you somewhere and you're actually able to maintain this position, you can actually start to gently slide your arms up the wall, right? And she will notice that that actually makes this more difficult to do. And if she can still maintain this alignment, that's awesome. Some people can't because you're gonna start feeling restrictions or weakness in some of these areas. So you can literally make this, it can go straight from an assessment to an exercise and rest. Okay, so in the clinic, when I wanna address like the pectoralis muscle, right? This big meaty muscle in the front, that's usually the main culprit, especially issues with the wall angel. I'll put my thumb in there, I move them, I have their arm move in a variety of angles, but you can't always make it to your PT or massage therapist or chiropractor to get that done. So a lot of times people try and use a tennis ball or a lacrosse ball against the wall for mobility. I'm great with that. You just put it here, you try to get into the big meaty muscle. Obviously my preferred choice is to use the Mobo. One, because it has a wand, so I have some distance now from the wall. I've got some leverage from my own body. I can get into this meaty part of the muscle and actually recreate what I do in the clinic, right? Which is get into that and actually have some movement, a pin and release, if you will, of that tissue. And so by having some space against the wall, this is how you can get into that tissue a little bit deeper. Okay, so a couple of safety tips for working on the pec musculature. Females, you don't wanna get into breast tissue, so if you think about just placing a hand over the pec muscle, basically you're looking for the ridge of the clavicle, right? This, your collarbone, and do not get into the armpit. So anything sort of within this area is gonna be where the meaty muscle is. You'll know if it's uncomfortable as far as like, don't touch a nerve where you're feeling any kind of zinging or tingling or numbness. You wanna stay in this muscle area. Now this muscle though is going to be very sensitive to touch, especially if it's dysfunctional, right? Muscles tend to have a little bit of sensitivity to them. So she's gonna place the end of this wand, or again, the ball, in that muscle belly. Once we come to the wall, here's where you can just get some leverage, get into that muscle, and then now what Lucy can do is take that arm that she's pinning and travel up, and then travel out like the angel she did on the wall. And you can open up and expose that muscle belly, and then you can certainly take the end, the tip, and or ball, and just sort of change locations as you feel like something releasing or you feel like that's a little bit too much, you can move to a different area. I like this stance that she's taking, that way she can also put as much pressure as she feels comfortable into the wall. So once you're in this position too, as you change the area that you're touching, spend about 10 seconds there and then move on. Basically, to cover the entire pectoral muscle, it's usually about 5 or 6 little different areas of contact. Also, if you do have the Mobo wand, you can do a little bit of cross friction, which means she can take this opposite hand and sort of gently kind of move it back and forth, and that sort of would recreate what I'm doing in the clinic with my thumb. I usually get in there and kind of strum across it a little bit. I don't think it's as easy to do with a ball against the wall, but either way, if you can sort of get in there, move that tissue, find a variety of locations, and move that arm if you can. So once you've completed mobilizing both sides of the pec, and then Lucy, you can hand me that wand, now she's gonna go into just a general pec stretch. There's several ways you can do this. Again, you need a wall or a corner or a door frame, but even here, Notice she can just open that up and then she just turns her body away from the wall. Again, this is a gentle stretch, don't force anything. Once you're here, this is for pec major. She can also slide her arm up to 45, get a little bit of that pec minor. Then she can also bend that elbow and come out, and then again, sort of wherever you feel the resistance and this restriction the most. But these are just three different angles that you can do against the wall just to gently try to open that pec up. Then you can always come back and try your wall angel again and see if you've made any progress. Again, trying to see if you can get those hands and wrists flat to the wall. So thank you, Lucy, for helping me with the wall angel. Remember the wall angel, that's the way you can assess shoulder mobility, thoracic spine mobility, you can look at your flexibility of your pecs. This is something that you can do every day if you're at work and you don't have a way to do the other pieces of this. Anything or any part of this that you can do will be very helpful for posture. And then also, don't think that you might make changes instantly, right? Some of you have had severe postural dysfunction for a long time, it's gonna be like peeling an onion. You gotta get layer by layer, right? This is a slow and steady process. Other people, you guys are gonna find some very dramatic results after one or two areas of mobilization. You're gonna see that thing change significantly and it'll give you some feedback on, you know, being able to do this more or less often. So those of you who really are gonna struggle with this, use this as your tool to manage and gauge your progress. So once you're done with your wall angel, if you have a friend or somebody who could actually take some pictures of you or maybe even video you in those positions so you can actually see the kind of progress you're making, I think that would be really helpful. Don't forget too, I have four more videos coming up of some other assessment tools that look at some other areas of dysfunction and restriction for flexibility and mobility coming up in the next series.
We at Wellness Plus specialize in all things health and wellness, ranging from yoga and fitness to massage and ASMR. Whether you are looking to target specific areas of tension or want to enhance your general self-care routine, we provide the tools you need to feel better, look better, and live better. We have courses for every level, whether you're just starting out or you're a seasoned pro. Our courses provide a wide range in difficulty to accommodate your evolving flow.
Welcome back to Yoga with Jess. We are going to break down some really essential postures.
We are going to rock out with some of the most essential ab exercises that you need to have the abs that you've always dreamed of.
I've blended techniques to help you connect with students and you can be a rock star teacher.
Wellness Plus is available on your phone, tablet, or TV. Join Wellness Plus today and get your first 7 days free.